Hi everyone, welcome to day 3 of the Good Form versus Bad Form series. My name is Matt Carvalho. I am the group fitness coordinator here at the Old Colony YMCA in Taunton. Today I am outside and I'm going to show you a technique that I see a lot of the times been done completely wrong, and it is called the crisscross, or some of you may have known it as bicycle crunch. So what I will typically see in the gym is that the elbows are nice and like this, and they're trying to touch elbow to knee and really going with momentum in the movement. And that's actually incorrect. You're actually tugging at the neck and you're using momentum to engage through the transverse abdominals, the quadratus lumborum, all the deep internal abdominal muscles, instead of really getting that rotation through the obliques and so much more. So I'm going to show you how to do it the correct way. So starting at the base level, you can just simply rest your head on the mat like so, especially if you're not used to being in Pilates stance, as this is what is typically referred to. So even if you just want to start with this, and you'll just tap one foot to the floor, not even moving the upper body, okay? Now, if you want to intensify that a little bit, you'll come up into Pilates stance, elbows are nice and wide, hand is on the nape of the neck, the gaze is forward, not at the ceiling right over here, so that will create less tension in the neck. And all I would want you to do is to just rotate like so, just leading with the shoulder, not with the elbow, so that you'll really get that nice rotation through the spine in order to target those obliques, transverse abdominals, etc. Now, if you want to take it up a notch, the full version of the crisscross looks like this. So knees, stack them right over the hips, ankles in line with the knees, hands behind the nape of the neck, leading with the opposite shoulder towards opposite knee, opposite shoulder towards opposite knee. Now, if you are a tiny human grower or somebody who's not comfortable being on their back, what you can do is do a lateral flexion from side to side. So hands behind the nape of the neck, and you'll tilt to the side, come center, tilt to the side, come center, okay? I hope that helped you in your crisscrosses. Let me know what you want to see next time, and I will see you then. Bye.